Here, now I'm talking about the Ardhanarishra in murals of Kerala. Okay, Ardhanarishra is the form of god Shiva depicted along with his consort Parvati in a single body, depicting the left half of a feminine body and right half of a male body. It symbolizes that the male and female principles are inseparable. It represents the reconciliation of the opposites like Purusha and Prakriti, Nara and Nari, matter and spirit, and Pita and Mata. Shiva represents Purusha, the male principle, and Shakti represents Prakriti, the female principle. The union of Purusha and Prakriti is believed to generate creation and ultimately the universe. The concept of Ardhanarishra has a profound inner meaning. The deity symbolizes the optimal balance of this male and female energy is in the world, and also indicate that they are essentially inseparable forces, which are complementary to each other and must work together to maintain the equilibrium. It shows the unity in the opposite of Purusha and Prakriti. Then the Ardhanarishra form of Shiva has been described in various Puranas like Shiva Purana, Markandeya Purana, and the description of Ardhanarishra image is given in texts like Amshubhedagama, Kamigagama, and Suprabhedagama, Silparatna, etc. There is a popular Tamil legend relating to the emergence of Ardhanarishra, that is the story related with the Rishi Bringi. Once the god and the rishis gathered at Shiva's abode and paid their respect to Shiva and Parvati. However, one particular rishi named Bringi had vowed to worship only Shiva as the supreme deity. He therefore ignored Parvati and continued his worship of Shiva, offering circumambulation to him. Then the Parvati became furious and cursed Bringi that he would lose all his flesh and blood and thereby reduced him to mere skeleton. Then Bringi could not stand erect in this form, and so the compassionate Shiva blessed him with a third leg for support. Deeply hurt, Parvati decided to punish herself by undertaking severe austerities which pleased Shiva. He granted her the boon of uniting with him forever, thereby compelling Bringi to worship her as well as himself in the form of Ardhanarishra. However, the sage assumed the form of a beetle, circumambulating only in the male half, drilling the hole in the navel area of the deity, which separated the male half from the female half. Though not entirely pleased, Parvati was amazed by his devotion to her lord, reconciled with Bringi and blessed him. Then, in most representations, the Ardhanarishra figure, we can see the right half is usually Shiva and the left half is Shakti. The right half, Shiva, always shown as wear Yadamaguda, top of his head adorned with the crescent. Sometimes this Yada is also ornamented with the snakes and the Ganga. Flowing this stream through the hair, the right ear is Sarpa Kundala. In some witches, the male eye is depicted as smaller than the female ones, and a half mustache is also seen. In the two armed form, the Shiva always depicted with two arms, and in the two armed form, he holds right hand Parashu or Trishula, and the other shows Varada Mudra. The male half of the body has a flat masculine chest, broader shoulder, wider waist, and muscular thigh. In North Indian images, may portray the male aspect half nude. However, South Indian portraits always have the tiger skin or sarpa mekhala or serpent girdle. Then Shakti, the left half. The left half of the Ardhanarishra is portrayed with feminine body. The female half of the deity is shown having Karadamaguda. The well-combed hair is neatly held in a place. In the case of two-armed icons, the left hand rests on the Nandi's head, hang loose or hold a flower, Nilolpala or lotus. In some cases, she is depicted with single-handed. And the female half of the deity has a well-rounded full bosom and narrow feminine waist embellished with various aras or waistband. She is also adorned with other ornaments made of diamonds and other gems. The female part of the body is always fully clothed. She wears multicolored silken garment down to her ankle. Usually the Shakti half is located to the left of the Ardhanarishra, and Shiva is shown on the right side. Traditionally too, the wife is seated to the left of the husband, and hence she is known as Vamangi. And the right side is often associated with the masculine traits and cerebral functioning such as logic, direction, systematic thought, etc. And the left side is related to the her, therefore is also associated with the typical feminine characteristics such as creativity, intuition, etc. Then coming to this cultural representation of Ardhanarishvara, the iconography motifs of Ardhanarishvara was evolved at very early period. The Ardhanarishvara aspect of Shiva in the plastic art of India is to be found in Kushana relief in Madura region. Several sculptures representing this theme have been found throughout India. In South India, the early type of Ardhanarishvara is found in the Dharmarajarath at Mahabalipuram, a masterpiece of Pallava art, and another image is from Kailasanatha temple at Kanji. A very graceful form of Ardhanarishvara is in Tribhanga pose, is from Ayyappa, belong to early Chalukya period. And the magnificent sculpture of Ardhanarishvara is found in Rocket Cave at Badami. During Chola period, a plenty of images in the Chola temples in Tamil Nadu like Thiruvaram, Urayur, etc. And then Ardhanarishvara image found at Kumbakonam is one of the most finest, the finest example of Chola period. Both seated and standing image of Ardhanarishvara are represented in Vijayanagara temples. In Kerala, it is found during 12th century. Coming to Kerala temples, the Ardhanarishvara figure is appears only after medieval period. During medieval period, belongs to 12th century. I think the sculpture representation of Ardhanarishvara in Kerala temples will discuss Kumbodharan in his paper. So now I am going to talk about the representation of Ardhanarishvara in temple murals of Kerala. In temple murals, it appears only after 17th century. That is, belongs to the second medieval period. After medieval period, at presently, four temple murals have the panel of Ardhanarishvara, and it is reported from Vagamoli Mahavishnu Temple, Loganarkav Bhagavathi Temple, Pundarikapuram Mahavishnu Temple, and Kottakkal Venkatadeva Shiva Temple. The Vagamoli Mahavishnu Temple is one of the most celebrated Vishnu shrine of Kerala, located near Koyilandi in Kozhikode, in northern Kerala. And here the mural themes are depicted around the walls of the square-shaped Sri Kovil. It consists of seven large panels and eight small panels arranged around 200 square feet area. The important themes depicted here are various iconographic incarnations of Lord Vishnu like Varaha, Navagriha Narasimha, Venugopala Krishna, etc. And then Ganapati worship, Kali on Vedala, Ayyappahan, and syncretic incarnations of Lord Shiva like Harihara and Ardhanarishvara. This is the image of Ardhanarishvara in Vagamole Mahavishnu Temple. It is seen on the eastern corner of the southern wall. And here we can see the demarcation of the Ardhanarishvara figure. But the demarcation is visible only in the body color. No demarcation has been seen in the ornaments and other costumes of the figure. The Shiva aspects are presented in the right side of the image and Shakti aspects are shown in the left side. And the image is depicted with standing with three hands. The upper right hand called Parashu and lower right hand is in Bharata Mudra showing Shiva aspects. And the Shakti side shown, left hand is in Abhaya Mudra showing Shakti aspects. Then coming to the next temple, it's the Loganarkav Bhagavathi temple. Loganarkav is one of the most popular Bhagavathi shrine in North Kerala, located about 4 kilometers away from Vadagara in Kozhikode district. And this it is a temple complex and it has three shrines dedicated to Durga, Shiva and Vishnu. Here the mural paintings are depicted on the Sri Govil walls of Durga shrine. The important things depicted here are Harihara, Ardhanarishvara, Kidadamurti, Dakshinamurti, Parashurama, Goddess Saraswati, and Lakshmi. This is the image of Ardhanarishvara in Loganarkav Bhagavathi temple. It is depicted on the right side of the Sri Govil wall. Means the Sri Govil faces to, the temple faces to eastern direction. It is seen on the southern part of the eastern wall, and the northern part you can see the image of Harihara. The figure is shown as standing on a lotus pedestal. The Shiva aspects are presented in the right side of the image with white color, and the Shakti aspects are shown in the left side with golden yellow color. And it is a standing 400 image The upper right hand called Parashu, lower right hand Varada showing Shiva aspects, and lower left hand Varada and upper left hand called lotus flower showing Shakti aspects. The demarcation has been visible in the body color and costumes. The costumes we can see the tiger skin, but below the knee there is no demarcation. The in the Ardhanarishira figure, the similar costumes can see the below the knee portion. Then coming to the third temple, that is Kottakkal Venkatadeva Shiva temple. Venkatadeva Shiva temple is located in Kottakkal taluk of Ernad district in Malappuram. The chief deity is Lord Shiva along with his spouse Parvati. There are 40 different mural themes are depicted on the walls of Garbhagriha. The date of the mural and the name of the artist are inscribed here. Only 3 temple murals of Kerala have the mural painting with the inscriptions. This is one of the most important temple murals of Kerala with the inscriptions. The date of the mural is 1866 to 1878 AC. That is belongs to 19th century. And the name of the artist also written here. That is Shankaran Nair and Bharatha Pisharani. Then the important mural themes. Here the entire Sri Kovil walls are fully embellished with the beautiful mural themes. The important mural themes depicted here are various incarnations of Lord Vishnu like Vaikunthanatha, Narasimha, Parashurama, Krishna, Rama, Pattabhishega, etc. And Shiva, various incarnations of Shiva are Kiratamurthy, Akhoramurthy, Nadaraja, Dakshinamurthy, Ardhanarishvara, Harihara. And also the mural artist give importance to depicting Shakti goddesses like Parvati, Lakshmi and Saraswati. Then this is the Ardhanarishvara image depicted on the Kottakkal Venkatadeva Shiva temple. It is seen on the northeastern corner of the temple. The image is depicted as standing on a lotus pedestal. The Shiva aspects are presented in the right side of the image with white color, and Shakti aspects are shown in the left side with golden yellow color. And it is also depicted with the four-handed. And upper right hand called Parashu, lower right hand is in Varada Mudra showing Shiva aspects. And upper left hand Pasha and lower left hand lotus showing Shakti aspect. The demarcation has been mainly visible in the color of the body, kirida and costumes except in the ornaments. Then coming to the last temple, that is Pundarikapuram Mahavishnu temple. It is situated on a small hillock called Midaikunnam on the southern bank of the river Muvattura near Thalaiyilappuram in Kottayam district. The principal idol is the Garuda Vahana Vishnu. It is a rare icon, that is the Vishnu along with the Bhumi Devi sitting on the back of Garuda. And that Garuda Vahana Vishnu accompanied by Bhumi Devi. The temple is presently protected under the control of State Archaeology Department. And the important mural themes depicted here are Ummasagida Shiva, Mahishasura Mardini, Krishna Leela, Rama Pattabhishega, Nadaraja, Yakshi, Ardhanarishvara, Harihara, Ayyappa Han and Ganapati Varshi. And this is the Ardhanarishvara figure depicted in the Pundarikapuram Mahavishnu temple. It is seen on the southern side of the eastern fourth door. The image is depicted as standing on a lotus pedestal. The Shiva aspects are presented in the right side of the image with the red color. Then while the Shakti aspects are shown in the left side with yellow color. The upper right hand, it is a four-handed image, and the upper right hand hold Parashu, and lower right hand is in Varada Mudra showing Shiva aspect, and the upper left hand Pasha and lower left hand hold lotus showing Shakti aspect. When we analyzing the theme, a question, automatically a question will arise in our mind, that is, what is the reason behind this color demarcation? It may be due to the relationship of mural theme and the principal idol kept on the Sri Kovil, which means still the mural artist of Kerala following the, they selected these themes on the basis of descriptive mantras like Dhyana Slogas. And in Dhyana Slogas, the Ardhanarishvara explained in different ways. First one, Shiva, white Shiva along with the red colored Parvati. And then another way of representation is red Shiva along with the yellow Parvati. The mural artist selected this theme on the basis of their worship. For example, if they worship Ardhanarishvara for fulfilling any special, any of their wishes or needs, they selected white Shiva along with the red color Parvati. For getting protection or abhaya, they worship red Shiva along with yellow Parvati. For here we can see the principal idol of the temple is Garuda Vahana Vishnu. Here the people coming here mainly for getting protection or abhaya. That is the concept behind the worship of that principal idol. I think it is also reflected in the depicting this mural scenes. That may be the reason of this color demarcation. Then concluding my observation, Lord Shiva is one of the important deity in Kerala painting. About 10 different iconographic form of Shiva are magnificently depicted in the temple murals of Kerala. All these themes appears in Kerala murals only after 16th century onwards. Before that, the earliest paintings in Kerala is reported from Tirunandikira Rocket Temple, which is dated to 8th to 9th century. But during that period, the murals of Kerala became more natural. They selected natural things for depicting natural scenes. While after 15th century CE onwards, the murals of Kerala become more iconographic in nature. It may be due to the influence of second Bhakti movement happened in that contemporary society. During that period, many iconographic forms appears in Kerala murals. And the Nadaraja Shiva, around 25 temples of Kerala have the image of Nadaraja Shiva, and Dakshinamurthy reported from 10 temple murals. Ummasahitha Shiva, another important iconographic incarnation of Lord Shiva, it is from 7 temples. Then 6 temples have the image of Aghoramurthy. Then Harihara reported from 5 temples, Ardhanarishira from 4 temples, then Kidadamurthy from 3 temples, and Markandeya Anugrahamurthy from 3 temples, and Kamandakamurthy is also reported in temple murals of Kerala. It is from 1 temple. Then another important question, that what is the synchronization reflected in these murals? Then when we analyzing this temple murals, we know that Ardhanarishira is one of the most elegant theme in Kerala murals. These 4 images are depicted in different temples. That is, the temple one is from Shiva temple, and another one is from Bhagavati shrine, and another 2 mural are reported from Shiva temple. 2 from Vishnu temple, 1 from Shiva temple, and 1 from Bhagavati temple. All these temples, we can see there is a kind of color demarcation. And color demarcation is the one important factor of this temple. The color demarcation is one of the characters are clearly visible in the temple murals of Kerala. Then compared to sculptures, we can see this color demarcation in murals. And Shiva is always depicted with white or red color. Most of the cases, Shiva is depicted with white color and Shakti is red color. And the amalgamation of this Shaivism and Shaktism can be reflected in the this temple murals. For example, in the Vishnu shrine, like Vagamoli Mahavishnu temple and Pundarikapura Mahavishnu temple, here the mural artists give importance to depicting Vaishnava icons along with Shaiva icons, and they also give importance to depicting Shakti divinities. The Vagamoli Mahavishnu temple, one of the eye-catching image of that temple is Kali on Vedala, along with the Shaivite and Vaishnavite iconographic incarnation. Then in Loganarka Bhagavati temple, we can see the image of Parvati, Saraswati, and Lakshmi, Shakti divinities, along with the Shaivite and Vaishnavite themes. And then in Kottakkal Venkatadeva Shiva temple, that temple also have the image of Parvati on the back of a bull, along with the Vishnu and Shaiva iconographic themes. And in Pundarikapura Mahavishnu temple, one of the most important theme is Mahishasura Mardini Durga, the Shakti goddess like Mahishasura Mardini Durga, along with the Vaishnavite and Shaivite themes. The deities, the selected, the introduction of Ardhanarishira in mural paintings in Kerala temple shows the real reflection of the society. They given generous importance to induct the Shakti element into the Shaiva element, Shaiva cult. Outcomes in the integration of 2 cult forming Ardhanarishira. These are my references. Then I would like to acknowledge Central Archaeology Department, State Archaeology Department, and various Devasam boards and various temple authorities. Then my supervising teacher, Professor Rajesh Kumar, Dr. Preeta Nair, HOD, Department of Archaeology, University of Kerala. Then Renu Iyer, my colleague, Rajesh SV, Dr. Abhin G.S. and Mr. Ranjesh Lal. Then Chitra Banu sir and K.K. Mara, Mr. A. Muhammad for photo documentation. Then teaching staff and students, the Department of Archaeology, University of Kerala. Thank you.